locomotives. Probably a truck, probably Carmen or something. Thank you. not in the frame right now. Because I'm just watching this other train that rolled out a minute ago. It's probably going to throw that switch over to go over with the head up into the fuel rack. These big road engines.
That's where that hole got from.
One dry good. There is one dry good on the tail of this thing. You can see a lot of these wells are owned by BNSF. You can see the badge.
Yep.
Shield on the side. Oh, there are those guys coming off.
There's.
Guys are coming off their engines, their cases. Still don't know what's in those. Put that right in front of us. They're pulling a line of center beams and box Amtrak is pretty quiet when it comes zooming through. So, yeah, so probably at the first, second week of June, I'll start talking to him about dates for going to North Platte. Yeah. Yep, he's lined for pit. They call this configuration where they're running nose to nose. Because we've never seen it like this. No. Because this is the inverse of how it is normally where they're running tail to tail. Yeah, that's when they're running in the same. Remember, if I miss Amtrak, it's no big deal. We catch it a lot. Caught it last week.
Chat started with it.
I gotcha. Think he even changed tracks. Yeah, I'm gonna catch that on film. I haven't caught this on film in a while. Yep, looks like we're finally loading out. That is so cool. You see how it kind of caught on the edge of the car?
Yeah.
There it goes. Good clear. Most likely, because he's pulled right in line with the car.
Hey, in the clear on the green line, bro.
Once he's got all four on and they're in the open position, he'll then give the loader the signal to drop it in. Yep, he pulled clear. Oscar's gonna take off. Yep, so he's lifted it clear and that Hostler should take off in a second. Yep, there goes the Hostler.
Yep.
With the chassis. And roll in.